Well, friends, I am Dr. Srinivas here from Department of PG Studies in Zoology, Veerashaiva College, Ballari. So here, just I'm going to talk about the camouflage and the mimicry in animals. Friends, animals are being wonderful creature in the nature, and they are the part of the aesthetic condition of nature, and their service is in the ecosystem is very much essential. As we study the animals, they are showing a wonderful behavior with respect to the adaptation, with respect to their behavior in the ecosystem, and their feeding mechanism, and their breeding mechanism. It is so wonderful to observe and even studies also. Friends, today I am going to give a brief insight of animals and their coloration behavior in different animals. Animal coloration is the general appearance of an organism or animal resulting from the reflection or emission of light from its surfaces. Animals produce color in both direct and indirect way. The direct production occurs through the presence of visible colored cells known as pigments. As we know that every organism, they have pigments in their body. Sometimes, you know, they have more pigments, sometimes, you know, less, or sometimes, you know, scattered pigments all over the body, which makes the color of the organism. Second one is indirect production occur by virtue of cell known as chromatophores, which are pigmented or pigment containing cells such as hair follicles actually. The second thing that you have to understand before going for organism coloration is the camouflage actually. The camouflage is the use of any combination of material, coloration or illumination for concealment, either by making animals or object or to see. This is what we call it as crypsis. So what is this? This is called as crypsis. An example including the leopard spotted coat. So in the future slides, and you know, on future slides you are going to see how this leopard is camouflaged with the nature. The leaf mimicking catadid wings actually. This is the insect. Then let us see that mimicry. Just I am giving the brief introduction about all these definitions actually. The ability for organism developed to imitate one or more traits from another organism with which it's unrelated, it is not at all related to the organism actually, so that it can obtain some benefit. So what is the mimicry? It is ability of organism to develop to imitate the other organisms actually. So the other organisms may not be the same species or may not be same genera actually. It can be any other, what is that, a genera too. On the other hand, mimetic animals go further and try to imitate not only morphological trait but physiological and behavior, looking for the response from the other things actually. Sometimes, you know, they are not only mimicking, just they even modify their body according to the other organisms. Like physiological and behavioral changes can be seen in this behavior. Dear friends, In camouflage and mimicry, you can identify where these two animals are located. Can you able to identify this? If you are identifying, okay, fine. This is wonderful organisms actually. I don't want to name the, what is that animal over here. Please identify this. We know that in camouflage, you have ever wondered why animals have spots, stripes or certain colors actually. So it is sometimes, you know, very difficult to understand why these organisms behave like this. Why do they have spots actually, stripes over the body and the whole coloration of the body. Sometimes an animal colors can be a difference between life and the death even. Sometimes, you know, during the lifetime they have a different color and after that, you know, the color will be changed. Animals use their color to blend into the environment. That is very, very important actually. That's what the Darwinian, what is that, definition says. It's an adaptation by natural selection actually. So they have to adapt to the nature. Where the nature is, based on nature, so animals try to adapt themselves in that. Otherwise, you know, there will not be any survival. What is this called actually? This is what we call it as adaptation, I personally feel. Camouflage is a type of an organism, is called as animal adaptation actually. Look at this. What is an adaptation then? You might see the picture at the right side where these organisms actually, how these organisms are camouflaged to the, that is that, adapted to their environment actually. An adaptation is something that helps animal to survive better. So survival of a test actually. It is one of the reasons of survival of a test, adaptation actually. Otherwise, you know, they cannot survive because of a lot of predator in the ecosystem. Find the crater. See, if you can find the camouflaged animal in these pictures, the animals you are looking for are dash, dash and dash. Please define and tell me. So please you find out where the animal is locating. It's so wonderful. Can you be able to see where the animal is? Unless the right picture is shown, you cannot identify the animal very easily. Then what is mimicry actually? Animal may also try to look like another animal, as I explained earlier also. For example, non-poisonous snakes will rattle their tail and flatten their head to look poisonous to a predator actually. We know that, you know, rattlesnake, how they make the sound actually, right? This is what we call it as mimicry, where animal try to mimic or copy others' behavior actually. Can you able to find which snake is poisonous in this? Other form of mimicry, see that. Another example of mimicry involves the monarch butterfly, which is toxic and very nasty to eat. Its bright orange coloration is warning to birds to leave it alone. The non-toxic Viscerae butterfly has developed the color and wing pattern that are very similar to those of the monarch, and so much birds won't take a chance to testing it actually. It's so wonderful to, what is that, getting the color like a monarch butterfly which is here actually. Can you able to find out a viper? And how big is this? Can you closely observe the manifest of scales over the animal? It's so wonderful organism, of course, it is very dangerous causing a snake. Can you able to locate the leopard of South America. Can you locate the flying cloth eater over the bark? And can you be able to identify where the animal is and what animal is this? And the same way here also, can you identify which mammal it is here? And can you be able to identify where the animal in this picture? And can you see this, how wonderful it is adapted to the nature? Of course, it is very difficult to identify where the organism here in this organism. Can you be able to identify and tell or analyze it? Here, so nice to see, it is so difficult to observe where the animals are in this picture. Please, you try to identify and tell. Here, look at the mimicry of these animals are, right? And find out where the animal and which is the animal here in two pictures. It's one of the amazing photograph. Can you identify the animal mimicry, how these animals are behaving during the mimicry? Here too. Oh, so gecko, where is it? And where is the flatfish? Coming to the types of what is that mimicry? We have Batesian mimicry. It's a form of a mimicry wherein one armless species that is palatable to a predator mimic the appearance of harmful or non-noxious species. For example, the harmful bee that can sting and cause harm to the predator will not be preyed upon. If a harmless insect evolved to adapt to the unpalatable bee appearance, then it will be mistaken as harmful and avoid actually. Look at this. It maybe like, you know, just it is somewhat like it. This is a, most probably you may not see this one, this is a tortoise beetle here and Theria beetle here. The armless Theria beetle mimic the noxious tortoise beetle. So this one is almost like, you know, what is that, mimicking the tortoise beetle here. Can you be able to identify which is the poisonous and which is the non-poisonous and see the coloration? Almost it looks very similar adaptation. The Mullerian mimicry. Two equally noxious species evolved to look similar to each other. As I said earlier, the postman butterfly, it looks almost like, you know, the common postman butterfly. The red postman butterfly, it develops into a common postman butterfly. So they have a breeding barrier, however, they develop the similar coloration actually. And you see, the aggressive mimicry is a form of a mimicry in which the predator, parasite and parasitoid share similar signals using a harmless model, allowing them to avoid being correctly identified by the prey or host actually. This is what we call it as a lantern anglerfish actually. It shows something like, you know, aggressive behavior, like almost a shark-like structure. And it shows the bioluminescent because of lantern or bioluminescenting organ present in this area which emits the light actually, and which helps them to capture the fish or sometimes, you know, escape from the predator. Can you be able to identify what is what here actually? Look. The ant mimicking spider of the genus. Here, the alligator snapping, turtle wiggling a small growth on the tongue within its open mouth actually. So here you can see that in a small opening of this thing. Arched mantis, it looks almost like, you know, the flower of the animal. The spider-tailed horn viper, like, you know, the tail is almost like, you know, what you call the spider-like structure type. This Iranian snake tail is shaped into a bulbous structure with thin legs jutting out that look just enough like a spider to lure, actually. Sometimes, you know, it attracts the insects so that the Iranian, what is that, snake, so this viper can catch the prey. This is kind of a mimic or mimicry things the animals can make. Defensive and protective mimicry take place when organisms are able to avoid harmful encounters by deceiving enemies into treating them as something else, actually. It is also responsible for camouflage of an animal by its close resemblance to its general background or to some dead or dull objects which is of no interest to its enemies, actually. A protective mimicry has two aspects, concealing, and the second one is warning, actually. A crab, cryptolithodes like pebbles, this is a crab actually, it looks like almost a pebbles actually. It looks like a stone pebble. So this is what the crab has adapted to themselves. The caterpillar of geometric mark, you cannot even identify this is the caterpillar, this is the caterpillar actually. So it looks almost like, you know, this is a geometric mark. Moth of the, what is that, stage of the moth, caterpillar, it looks almost like, you know, a small twig of the or a branch of the tree. In the moth Caesura, both caterpillar and adult show mimicry, actually. This one and this one, actually. Kallima paralecta, this is the insect actually. The wings look like almost leaf-like structure, actually. Walking stick insect, you cannot see where is the walking insect in this. So, this is the walking insect, actually. This is the walking insect. Oh, this is Australian fish. We call it as the Phylopteryx equus, which look almost like, you know, seaweed in the, what is that, sea area. Sometimes, you know, it is a wonderful warning mimicry. A non-poisonous hog-nosed snake, Heterodon, are capable of flattering the head, rendering it triangular-like hood, and is so as to show that they are dangerous. See that, you know, it is almost like in a wood-like structure and it shows a wide mouth as if it is very, very dangerous animal. Of course, it is a non-poisonous animal, an harmless animal. You have Cicia craboniformis, mimic to a dangerous wasp, waspa, crabro. This is the wasp here. It mimics actually like this. So this is about the interesting animals they show, that what is that camouflage or mimicry in this organism. Thank you. With this slide, you say that, you know, which one is the front and which one is the back of the organism actually. This is another wonderful, what is that, picture in the last slide. Thank you. Follow my other lectures on YouTube.